The Philippine Budget Department denies claims the government lost 1 billion pesos due to the purchase of alleged overpriced personal protective equipment. For more on this, we now have on the line DBM Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau. Good afternoon, USEC Lau. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good afternoon, po.
Seven contracts for PPE sets were awarded to China-based firms from April to May because no local supplier could comply with the DOH's required eight-piece PPE set budgeted at 2,000 pesos each. The DBM had actually released a statement on this procurement deal. What kind of challenges did you say the DBM encountered when sourcing these PPEs?
Well, as early as March, when COVID pandemic erupted in the Philippines, the government, I think the entire world, declared a lockdown. So there were no commercial vessels, neither were there any international airlines flying across borders or, in fact, within the country. So the first hurdle that we should consider during the time was to connect with the suppliers, either local or international. So nobody was mobile enough to contact each other. So how do we send the data, the invitation to bid, and for them to send samples, to send their bid requirements. And even when we contacted local manufacturers, the biggest problem they have is they can't source out the raw materials to produce the items that they need to buy, because most of the items come from China. And in fact, contacting China, it was very hard. We even attempted to get our own passports just to go to China to canvas the materials directly from that country. However, China has its own lockdown, so we cannot enter China. We have to go there and spend 14 days for quarantine. And even local manufacturers that has encountered the same problem. So during that time, it's a contest between getting the cheapest one and at the same time the maximum volume and to bring it to the Philippines in the earliest time possible. Because we are in need of at least 50,000 PPEs, entire Philippines. So how do you bring 50,000 sets of PPEs every day? So, and you know what, natin during the time, we contacted our DFAs, our ambassadors, to negotiate with the foreign countries who manufactures the COVID items and the PPEs. Kasi sila lang ang meron. And the fact that China experienced COVID-19 pandemic earlier than any other country, I think 3 months early. So during that time, they were able to have constructed several manufacturing companies already manufacturing PPEs to address the pandemic. However, the Philippines, kakapasok pa lang ng pandemic, wala pa tayong manufacturing companies noon. So we have to source everything from China. So nung nabili natin ang mga items sa China, our second problem is how to bring it to the Philippines kasi walang airlines, walang vessels. So at least we have several planes. We have the C-130s government, which was flying in and out daily to China just to pick up the PPE sets. So daily, kumukuha tayo ng at least 50 to 100,000 PPE sets. But that is not enough kasi kailangan natin ng bulk stockpile. So while we were doing it, the Navy or the Philippine Navy was traveling from the Philippines to China to pick up the bulk sets, around mga 250,000 sets to 500,000 sets. It took them at least 10 days from the Philippines going to China and another 7 days going from China traveling back to the Philippines. So all in all, 25 days minimum. I think 20 to 25 days bago sila nakabalik. So nung bumalik na sila, umabot tayo ng 250,000 sets na stockpile aside from the 50,000 PPE sets daily. During the time, slowly, nagkaroon na tayo ng confidence to negotiate. And slowly, during that time, nag-open up na rin yung mga different airlines, different vessels, commercial vessels, and nagkakaroon na tayo ng ECQ, GCQ, slowly. So yung mga local businessmen, nagkakaroon na sila ng mobility. They went to my office and started offering their services to supply. Pero hindi pa local manufacturers yun. Mga ano pa lang yun? Importers, distributors. So, nag-open up tayo sa kanila, asking them how much they are willing to or capable of supplying and at a good price. So, they gave us several prices. Yung mga mura, binigyan natin. But they cannot even accommodate 500,000 or 1 million sets. Diba? Kasi parang, bakit hindi natin binigay sa kanila? Eh, yung 1 million sets, that if you multiply that to at least, let's say, 1,700 or 1,900, magkano yan? Diba? Do you have the capital to pay it sa China, then send it here, then wait for the Philippine government to process payment for like 30 days to 60 days? Who has that much capital? So, dun yung challenges sa local suppliers. Then after, I think, mga 45 days, while negotiating with DTI, BOI, and some local manufacturers, nag-repurpose sila. Now, we went to the next challenge naman. While nag-repurpose sila, kailangan bumili muna sila ng machines sa China again. Kailangan sila bumili ng raw materials sa China again. And after buying that, they have to bring it here, establish a manufacturing company, a factory that will be within standards. Tapos yung na-produce nila, ipapadala natin yung sa DOST and sa FDA. Tapos ipapadala din nila dun sa third entity or private entity who's was capable of testing these items, whether it's medical grade or not. So, umaabot din ng six weeks yung testing. So, until then, hindi sila pwede mag-supply. Kasi, una, wala silang capacity. Pangalawa, inaayos pa yung manufacturing company nila. Pangatlo, kailangan nila i-test yun. Kasi sa DOH, may standard sila, hindi ka pwede mag-supply kung wala kang ISO certificate, wala kang appropriate testing that is medical grade. Kasi pag pinasuot natin, kung tayo lang mag-a-assess, paano pagpasok ng paggamit ng mga health workers? Hindi pala fit yun. Hindi pala appropriate medically. So, useless yung binili natin. Nagkakasakit pa rin yung mga personnel. Now, the last challenge that we encountered is nung natapos na ng mga manufacturing companies yung local companies nila, test na lahat, now they want to supply. Ang problem naman is their capacity, because we need 50,000 a day and we need to stockpile at least 5 million PPE sets. During that time, March to May, wala ho silang capacity to produce that much. I think now, I talked to some companies, we have EMS, a surgical a manufacturer of surgical masks, N88, medical grade, pumasa na ho siya ng mga test, a license sa FDA, they are selling it to me at $14.50 a piece. And during that time, when we bought it, in local, abot pa ng 22 pesos ata ang mga surgical masks. We were able to close it with them by June at $14.50. So medyo mura. So binili kagad namin. May contract kami sa kabila. Ang second one is the N95 mask. Kasi ang N95 mask, last December, I think ang benta niya, around 30 pesos lang. Tapos nung tumutok yung taal, umabot siya ng 100. Na nagkaroon ng COVID ngayon, umabot na siya ng 200 to 250. But wala tayong nabili talaga niyan from March to May. Scarcity talaga kasi 250 yung benta nila. It's way beyond DTI pricing regulation. So hindi bumili ang PSEBN. We bought a substitute which is the KN95 at 100 pesos. Now, lately, by June, natapos din si Sunwest Corporation ng manufacturing company nila with their warehouse and manufacturing area dun sa may, I think, Laguna. And they offered the N95 locally produced at 100 pesos. So bumili na din tayo sa kanila. Slowly, nagkakaroon na tayo ng local capacity. And we are now patient to entertain them kasi slowly din, naka-stockpile din tayo kasi 5 million yung binili natin for the last 3 months, 5 million PPE sets. Meron pa po tayong 2 million na stockpile that will last us for October or I think hopefully until November. So during the second phase of Bayanihan, ang bibili na natin most likely are local manufacturing products. So hopefully ganun po. But the problem challenge again is under procurement law, 15% lang po yung margin that allows the local manufacturing company to have a higher price compared to imported price. So we will see when Bayanihan 2 takes effect, when we bid out, sana manalo sila.
You've brought up a lot of good points there. So you're saying it's not just about the price, but also the capability to manufacture and deliver at the soonest possible time. Then, of course, there's also testing. Then would it be worth the 25% alleged overpricing or premium pricing? Isn't volume of order, USEC, supposed to be a good reason to lower the price by a substantial amount?
Yes, ma'am. The problem is during that time it's a loss of supply and demand. In fact, we are having a big problem because internationally, when you go to China, the Philippines is one of the poorest buyers. We are competing with European countries and Western countries. In fact, that's why we were not able to buy N95 masks, because U.S. was willing, or America or Western countries and European countries, we're willing to buy it at 200 pesos a piece, which is around $4. And the budget of the Philippines is around 100 pesos only. Now, as to other items like surgical masks, coveralls, we were scampering and buying it because America and other Western countries were buying it in bulk at a much higher price. So, yung natitira, yun po ang binibili natin. Whatever is, you can say it's leftovers, but a few of the items that we were able to get, We bought it at a good price.
Well, the reports say the PPE sets are overpriced by 200 to 500 pesos each when compared with the Philippine General Hospital's estimated price of 1,200 to 1,500. Do you think that there had been an inflation of the prices? Plus, if there had been a negotiated contract for the sourcing of these PPEs, there hadn't been a bidding.
In response to that, we actually wrote a letter to
USEC Lau?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
In response to that, we actually sent a letter to PGH and to Senator Hontiveros to get the exact data and the documents which would substantiate that PGH was able to buy such items at 1,200 to 1,500. And yesterday, we were able to get a letter response from PGH, and they responded that they did not buy any 8-piece item at amounting to 1,200 to 1,500. However, they were able to procure several items from December until at present, one item at a time, with a very small quantity, around 20,000, 50,000 items, but it's individual items. So whatever comes to them, they buy, but mostly, they are dependent on donation from private entities and from the DOH, wherein DOH also gets their supply from the procurement of PSDBM info. So I don't know where they got the 1,200 and 1,500, but as far as our conversation with PGH is concerned, they haven't bought any PPE sets with the 8-piece item at that price.
USEC, if there hadn't been any bidding, there had been a negotiated contract, how do we ensure that we're getting the best deal?
The only assurance we can give is that we open it to everybody. We just don't negotiate with one entity. We tell everybody what's our buying price, and whoever agrees at that price or goes lower, then we deal with them, provided that they provide all the necessary documentations required by FDA, DPI, and DOH. So we don't negotiate with just one or two. We open it to everybody. Hindi lang po limited sa time frame. Kasi if we limit it to time frame, we tried it before. We were sending you the documents. We tried bidding it initially. When we bid it to local entities, they bid it at double the price. So medyo, that's the reason why we back down on bidding it. Because when you bid it, it's limited time. Very few people can participate. Like once we bid it up, the entire PPE sets, one company bid it more than 2,000 pesos. In overall, which we can buy before at 1,000, somebody bidded it at around 1,700. The face shield that should have been being sold in the market at around 200 pesos, somebody bidded it in local at 350 pesos. So with that, the problem is very few entities participated in the bidding. We stopped the bidding and just contacted all local suppliers and international suppliers.
Whoever
can give us the cheapest. Yes, ma'am.
We don't have much time anymore, but considering that we're still in the middle of this pandemic, how much in PPEs and other consumables related to COVID-19 are we still sourcing at the moment? Are we undergoing a bidding process right now? And what about the process of beefing up the capabilities of our local manufacturers? Who is that supposed to be the responsibility of? Is it the DTI, the LGUs? Until we're able to find a vaccine, the budget now will be sourced. Is it from Bayanihan too?
First, we have suspended our procurement on the PPEs because we have stockpiled more than enough until November. We will start procuring again after the publication of Bayanihan 2, which will now allow us to continue our procurement. We only spent half of the budget for PPE during Bayanihan 1, which is the same fund that we will be using for Bayanihan 2. Luckily, the prices have started to go down since all countries have started to ease up their requirements for the PPEs. Now, DPI, DOI, are currently working together with DOH and PSEBM in educating our local manufacturers to accredit themselves in order to allow themselves to supply PPEs to the Philippine government. In fact, we already have two local manufacturing companies that have contracted with the Philippine government, or PSEBM, which is the producer of N95 and the N88 mask. Second, as to the COVID test or PCR test procurement, the Philippine government is suspending, or the PSEBM is suspending, further procurement at the moment because due to our direct contracting to local to the manufacturers of the agents, the extraction kits, the detection kits, like MERSES, A-Star, Fortitude, and SunSure, we are contacting them directly, the manufacturing companies. We were able to get it at least 40% to 50% cheaper, which enabled the Philippine government to procure at least more than 50% more than it was intended to procure. So we are stockpiling until now, and we deliver pa po si SunSure sa Philippines.
How many is that, Yusek?
We were able to buy at least, I'll check, PCR tests, the kits, the total tests, we were able to buy 4 million po extraction and detection kits, that's 4 million pieces, 4 million pieces, then the detection kits is 4 million.
From the original 2 million, is that correct?
Yes, yes, po. We were able to double it. So umabot po tayo ng almost 8 million items. Mm-hmm. Meron din po tayong nabiling mga extraction kits. So we have tatlo kasi yan, we buy three things. We have the extraction and detection kit, which is a complete set, which is sold by SunSure. Then we have detection kits being used by other open source PCR and extraction machine. Then we have extraction kits.
Mm-hmm. To your credit, that actually means some 1.2 billion pesos in savings for the DOH. Is that correct, Yusek?
Yes, the 1.2 billion is our savings for being able to buy at 40 and 50% discount from the manufacturing companies.
And since this is still going to...
We will be using this amount later to buy a PCR test, maybe, if needed by the government, or make it a savings that may be used someday for vaccine procurement when the vaccine is readily available.
All right. On that note, DBM Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau, thank you so much again for joining us and enlightening us on the issue. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Mom.
And stay safe, sir.